Praise the Lord. Welcome to another episode of Touch of Healing, a program designed to bring God's word in a few minutes, about 10 minutes or less, and praying the prayer of faith. The Bible says the prayer of faith will save the sick and the Lord will raise him up. And if he had committed sins, they will be forgiven. My desire is to bring God's word in a short time and to help everyone going through challenges, tough times, sickness, disease, any kind of affliction to come out of it. Because the Bible tells us that Jesus already paid for all our sins, all our sickness, all our diseases. In short, if we read the Bible properly, we discover that nobody ought to be sick, nobody ought to be poor, nobody ought to be oppressed, because Jesus himself bore our sins and all the consequences of sin. You know, sin is the reason why people are sick. It doesn't mean the individual may have sinned, which is also possible. But sometimes it's because of the lineage of sin we have through the first man, the Bible calls Adam. You see, through Adam, sin came into this world, and death through sin. And because of sin and death, everyone became subject to sickness and disease, to sin, to death. But thank God, the Bible tells us 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ came and paid the price of sin and dealt with the devil and death. So now we are released from sin, we are released from sickness, we are released from disease, if we can believe. And so the only expectation of God's word for us to receive what Jesus has done is faith. Today, I just want to mention what I call strong faith. Strong faith. I'm reading from Romans chapter number 4, and I'm reading verse 19. The Bible says, "And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body, now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb." Verse 20, "He staggered not at the promise of God, true unbelief, was strong in faith, giving glory to God." So here the Bible is talking about Abraham. The Bible says he was not weak in faith by not considering his body, which was as good as dead, not the deadness of Sarah's womb, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God. So here we see two different kinds of faith. There is weak faith and there is strong faith. Now, weak faith does not mean that the faith is not there. It's just that it is weak. And if it's weak, it can't carry much. It can't deal with much. I know some people can stand against headaches and backaches and stomach pains. But if it comes to some more deadly diseases, like cancer, tuberculosis, multiple sclerosis, and brain tumors, you know, it's like they don't see how they can come out of it healed. Now, so there is weak faith and there is strong faith. And the Bible tells us here how you can have a weak faith and what can result in strong faith. Verse 19 again, it says, "And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body, now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither the deadness of Sarah's womb." So he was not weak in faith by not considering what was going on. That means that if he has taken time to look at those things and focus his attention on the doctor's report, how he felt, what everybody's saying, the fear about a disease, the person's faith cannot be strong. So he was not weak in faith, not considering his body that was good as dead, nor the deadness of Sarah's womb. But the Bible says, verse 20, "He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God." So we see one of the ways he was able to express a strong faith was that he began to give glory to God. He began to talk about God's goodness, talk about what God has said, what God has done. He kept his attention on the word. So if you keep your attention on the symptoms, on the circumstances, on the diseases, on the doctor's report, on everything that's going on around, you will stagger. You will not be strong in faith. You will be weak in faith. But if you begin to give glory to God, you talk about God's word, you rejoice, even if it looks hard, even if it looks impossible. I know when we get a doctor's report, if anyone does, that is negative, nobody wants to rejoice about that. But the Bible tells us that one of the ways we can stay strong in faith is to give glory to God. So whatever you're going through right now, whatever it is, it may be physical, it may be emotional, it may be spiritual, it may be financial. If you're in a tough situation, don't focus on the negative. Don't begin to analyze it, wonder what you could have done wrong, wonder how it came to pass, why me, why now. If you keep your mind on that, you'll stagger in your faith. Your faith won't be strong enough to receive what God has promised. But instead, keep your eyes on the Word. Begin to give glory to God. Begin to thank God for the good things. Thank God that He paid for your sin. Thank God that He paid for our sickness and our disease. Thank God that by the stripes we are healed. Thank God that He supplies our need. Begin to give glory to God in private and in public. Now, that looks strange. People won't expect you to become sad or depressed if you're going through tough times. But the Bible says if you're going to stay strong in faith like Abraham, you're going to have to give glory to God. You're going to have to learn to rejoice in tough times. We're going to have to learn to talk about what God has said, what God has done, even in the midst of difficult situations. And as you're doing that, the glory of God will be manifested, the healing will be done. And I tell you, that's the key. The supernatural miracles. Strong faith. Not looking at the circumstances, looking at the Word of God and giving glory to God. Again, this is supposed to be a short message, and I'm going to be praying for you. Listen, even if you are in the last days of any terminal disease, you can be healed today. You can come out of the situation. You can be restored to perfect health. There is nothing impossible with God. So take your eyes off the symptoms. I know it can be hard because you may be having pain, but begin to thank God. Remember what the Word of God says. The Bible says, by the stripes of Jesus, we were healed. 1 Peter 2:24. Thank God for it. Thank God that you are saved. Thank God that He died for you. Thank God that God loves you. And as you're doing that, your faith is strengthened and you can receive whatever miracle it is that you need right now. If you're watching this, you can just stretch your hand towards the screen if it's a television, or you can hold your phone or an iPad, whatever it is you're using. Use it as a point of contact as we pray. Because I believe as I pray, the anointing of God is going to come through me, through the screen, to where you are, and you're going to be healed. I'm joining my faith with you. I'm releasing God's word, God's power to bring healing, deliverance, salvation, restoration to you, your family, your children, and everything that you have need from God today in Jesus' name. Let us pray. But I thank you for your word. Your word says that you paid for all our sins, all our disease, all our sicknesses. Your word says that the chastisement of our peace was laid upon you, and by your stripes we are healed. So I stand with the word, and I come against every sickness and disease. Satan, I command you, take your hand off their bodies. Our cancer, I rebuke you, be gone. Migraine headaches, be gone. All kinds of skin disease, be healed in the name of Jesus. I say, be healed in your central nervous system. Be healed in your eyes, your back, every joint. Be healed in the name of Jesus. I command you to be healed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Every ungodly growth, I command you to shrink now and disappear in the name of Jesus. I command that heart condition to be healed. Lungs, be cleared up in the name of Jesus. Be healed right now from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I also declare breakthrough in your finances, breakthrough in your relationships, that the peace of God will come into your home and stay there. I come against all the quarrels, all the fightings, all the stress. Devil, take your hand. You spirit of confusion, remove your hand from this family in Jesus' name. From today, let there be a new grace, new joy, new peace, and a testimony of healing and restoration at work, at home, in the family, in the marriage, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Begin to give God thanks because miracles are happening. Give glory to God. Father, we rejoice for the miracles. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Again, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to this channel and share your testimony with us. Our information will be showing on your screen. You can text us, you can email us. Let us know what God has done. We want to be able to rejoice with you and share it with others. It could help other people to receive their miracles as well. Again, I look forward to seeing you in another episode of Touch of Healing. Till then, have a blessed day and remember to have and stay in strong faith. God bless you.